Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can quadruple your internet speed for free. You may have seen some of my previous videos describing how to increase your internet speed, but this one is by far the best method and it's very easy and only takes a couple of minutes. We're going to use some simple physics principles to modify our existing Ethernet cables, which will optimize the cable and maximize the throughput of our internet connection. We're also going to take advantage of the way ISPs deliver internet signals to maximize our speed. You see, when the internet company sends the signal to your house to connect to the internet, they are required, obviously, to give you the speed that you pay for. However, they know that over the long distance between their internet hub and you, there will be lots of signal degradation. So for example, if they want to provide someone with a 100 megabit connection, they actually have to initiate the connection with a much higher signal strength, or else by the time it got to you, it would be much slower. So in using a stronger internet connection signal, by the time it arrives at your computer, you'll have the 100 megabits you paid for. And when the ISP sends out the signal, they typically use about 4 times the desired final speed, because on average, the signal degrades by about 75%. Sometimes the signal may even degrade more, which is oftentimes the reason your internet speed may drop below what you're supposed to get on occasion. Here's the thing though. By far, most of the signal degradation occurs after it already enters your house. The internet lines that the cable companies use for internet are very high quality and degrade very little the signal over long distances. But the Ethernet cables you have in your house are actually relatively poor quality. They work well enough and most people don't even notice it, but they are actually very inefficient in reality. And these cables are the cause of most of the signal degradation of the electrical signal, and it occurs mostly between your computer and your router, not between the ISP and you. So if we can optimize the wires going into our computer, we can access the fully undegraded signal originally sent by the ISP. And because that signal degradation is not there that they were compensating for, we can access all of the signal. In most cases, this will mean that you will get about 4 times the internet speed that you're typically paying for and receiving. And if you're wondering about Wi-Fi, yes, that will also severely degrade the signal strength. Unfortunately, I haven't found a way to optimize the Wi-Fi signal yet, so we're going to stick to Ethernet cables for now. Now, to get started, you're only going to need a few things. They're household items, you shouldn't have any problem finding these. First is an Ethernet cable that goes to your computer. This is a very short one, but it's just as an example. Next, bear with me, but you'll need a flashlight. The brighter the better, but of course within reason. And finally, some aluminum foil, also known as tin foil. Either will work, doesn't matter if it's non-stick. Now, this is how it's going to work. You see, typical Ethernet cables, like other wires, use copper wiring inside. Copper is a very conductive element, which makes it good for transferring electricity. Now, from chemistry, we know that copper is what is known as a transition metal and has 1 electron in its outermost orbital. This means that that 1 electron is not tightly bound to the atom at all and is actually prone to escaping the electron cloud and moving around. So in this copper wire in the Ethernet cable, there are many extra electrons just moving around between atoms. This in turn causes a lot of interference, because the electrons from the internet signal have to compete with these random atoms moving around. However, if we can somehow manage to stabilize these electrons in some way, it would mean that the signal that we care about could pass through much easier with no interference. What we can do is use what is called the photoelectric effect, first discovered by Einstein. He discovered that when you shine light onto any material, it will emit electrons. So if we were able to emit electrons from the wires surrounding materials, these emitted electrons would then fill the outer electron shell of the copper atoms. Because the outer shell would then be full and stable, the electrons wouldn't move around anymore. Therefore, when the internet signal is transferred through the wire, it would no longer get all that interference. This is where the flashlight comes in. We can use it to cause the photoelectric effect and stabilize all the atoms in the wire, greatly increasing the wire's efficiency. So now that we know what needs to be done, let's go over to the table and I'll show you exactly how to do this. Okay, so here we have all our materials. We have the aluminum foil, we have the flashlight, and an Ethernet cable. I'm using a very short one just for a demonstration to save us some time. Yours will probably be longer. The first thing we need to do is wrap the cable with aluminum foil, and you want to make sure that basically all of this is covered. And this is just temporary, we're going to take this off after we're done. And you don't need a lot, so don't go and waste your whole roll of aluminum foil. Basically just 1 layer, about this much should be fine. And this is just so when we go to emit the electrons, nothing escapes and it all goes inside the wire as opposed to going out. It'll just make things go a lot faster. So after you have your cable mostly covered, looks something like this, we're ready to go on to the next step. So you'll want to grab your flashlight, and as I mentioned, the brighter the better, but there is diminishing return, so don't go out and use a huge spotlight or anything like that. And we just need to turn on the flashlight and point it directly in to the wire. And you might have to secure this with some tape or something. That's optional. Mine's cooperating. So what's happening here is even though the Ethernet cable uses copper wiring, they typically have small fiber optic filaments running down the length of it in the shielding. So that light will be transmitted through the shielding and the fiber optic cables, and then the electrons will be emitted into the copper wiring. So you just want to let this sit for about 2 minutes, and of course you do want to stay with it in case the flashlight gets too hot or something like that. We don't want anything melting, so just use common sense and keep an eye on it. And it doesn't matter which side of the cable you use, the fiber optic filaments will transfer the light throughout the whole cable, so it doesn't matter. So after about 2 minutes, you can turn off the flashlight, take it away, and unwrap the cable. Just take all the aluminum foil off. We do not need it anymore. So now this cable is finished, and you'll notice it does not look any different on the outside, of course, but when I go to do the test and show you, it is very obvious this cable is pretty special. And maybe if you want to mark it somehow for future reference to know that this is optimized, you could put maybe a piece of colored tape around it or something like that so you remember. And that's all there is to it. Okay, so at this point your cable should be fully upgraded, but of course we want to know how well it works. So why don't I go to the computer and I'll do a before and after comparison. Okay, so I'm at the computer and I'm going to do a test on speedtest.net. And first we're going to do a test without the cable that we made. It's the regular Ethernet cable from before. So we're going to do that one first, and then we're going to do it with the cable afterwards. So I'm just going to run it right here with the automatically selected server, and we can see what it is first. And it usually gives me a boost in the beginning. It's like a special feature they offer, but I pay for about 100 megabits a second, so it usually settles around there and a little bit lower. So it looks like it's gonna be about 100. So we're actually having a pretty good day today. It's actually getting the full speed, and for upload, it's not as good. It's kinda not up to 100. It's kinda dropping the 80s, but still pretty good. So I'm paying for 100. I'm basically getting 100, so that's not too bad. Hopefully it'll finish up soon. And then we can finish up and do the next test with the special cable. So here we have the results. We have 98.88 megabits per second and 97.16 megabits per second for the download and upload. And ping doesn't get affected by this. So we're gonna go on and do the next test. I'm gonna go replace it real quick and come back, and we can do the next test with the special cable. And it should be about 4 times more, so that'll be exciting. All right, so I just swapped out the cable and now it should be significantly faster, so we can do the test again right from where we left off. Same server and everything. Now it should be significantly faster. All right, so we still get a boost in the beginning, and it looks like it's even more than 4 times. So we more than quadrupled it. That's pretty amazing. I mean, this is an awesome internet speed. I don't even think they offer this kind of speed in any package you could even buy. So this is pretty awesome. And hopefully the upload speed will be just as good. Yep, it's getting that boost and it's dropping out to about the same. So it about quadrupled, even more so than quadrupled the internet speed. Again, the download is a bit faster than the upload, but this is an awesome result. We have more than quadrupled the internet speed. So obviously this cable worked, and this is a great result. So hopefully you guys will get a very similar result. So there you have it. Our internet speed was successfully quadrupled using this method in our upgraded special cable. Now it's important to remember that you might not get the exact same increase that we did. You could, for example, get a slightly slower or faster result depending on how much your ISP amplifies the original signal. If, for example, your internet company sends out a signal that is 5 times stronger, you'll get 5 times the internet speed. Also, the great thing about this is that the internet companies can't really do anything about it. They can't just weaken the signal because nobody else has the optimized cables. So this will work for you basically forever. So hopefully this did work for you, and I'm eager to hear from you guys about how well it worked for you. Did you possibly get an even faster internet connection from this? Be sure to let us know down in the comments section how well it worked. Also, if you did like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it, and be sure to subscribe because I make new videos every week. If you want, you can also follow me on Twitter. I'm very active over there. If you want to keep watching, I've got some other videos right here you can click on even if you're on a phone. It's a new annotation. So hopefully you enjoy those as well. I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.